Thank you so much for seeing us today. I see that you are starting a new series of paintings. Could you tell us a little bit about these new paintings?
新的系列我就是想画的比过去更简单一点，更单纯一点。其实，这是我一个最直接的一个原因。
Is this in reaction to the very large bamboo paintings you had made a few years ago?
对，我那个大画画够了，那个画太大了，我就所以在一二年之后，我画的几乎都是小幅的作品。Is
there a thematic relationship between the two?
没有理论上的联系，只有那个。
Well, let's go back a little bit to when you began your career. You had studied at CAFA, at the Central Academy of Fine Arts, and then you went to Europe. You went to the Hochschule der Kunst in Berlin, and then to the Rijksakademie in Amsterdam, and then you went to London, but we can talk about that later. But I think you went in 1989, so it's interesting to perhaps describe the events. I mean, was it after Tiananmen Square here? And I think you said, I think you were in Berlin when the wall came down. I mean, they were two very important events. What were your reactions to that, to them?
这个去柏林是正好时间上的巧合嘛，你知道，和89年没有什么关系，你知道，没有什么关系。然后那个柏林墙，我到了以后才开始，我也没想到它。 柏林墙倒了，你知道，也跟我去柏林没有什么关系，你知道，所以都是巧合，你知道，嗯。Because
sometimes you've been quoted or it's been discussed because they were such critical events, you know, that it did affect a lot of people and a lot of artists. And I'm just wondering, since you were in Berlin, what maybe the feeling was at that time, the sensations.
对，感觉就是。 因为我们当时受的教育在北京，一直认为东德和西德是两个国家，不，甚至都不太清楚他们之前是，就不久的之前是一个国家，你可以先翻，然后接着说。所以我到了那儿，我还挺惊讶的，就是德国统一会发生，然后当时我旁边的朋友同学都非常兴奋。 然后有各，当然还没有各种不同的看法，但是他们都特别兴奋。但是说句实在话，我没有那么强烈的那种，共鸣跟那个德国的统一。当然，我现在知道是这是多么重要的一件事情了。
So looking at your paintings, and looking at your paintings throughout, a lot of them look very Western European. Well, I know you've been interested in German expressionists, but they, to me, they look a little bit like Richard Lindner, richly colored, very, detailed. I mean, your palette is not quite the same, but the scale and the precision of drawing. Do you know him? And could you talk a little bit about those kinds of influences, the Western influences in your work?
Yeah. I think I remember.
Yeah,
it's a
very, very clean, very, you know,
man, woman
figures. Yeah, figurative, the, right?
Yeah.
And
I know. I get more. 我主要受的影响是那个早期北方文艺复兴的绘画 like Van Eyck.
Van Eyck.
Oh, Van Eyck. That's precise.
Yeah, or the Vermeer.
Vermeer.
Such artists had big influence on me. 就是更多的影响。
Well, Mondrian, you know, because Mondrian, cite him. Yeah. And of course, Dick Bruna.
Dick Bruna, yeah. That's got more influence.
Now, he was a Dutch illustrator of children's books.
Yeah.
And he created this character, Miffy,
yeah.
who was a rabbit.
yes. 像那个迪克布呢，对我来讲比达芬奇对我还重要一些。
It has been said that you identified with this Miffy, this rabbit. Can you talk a little bit about why you identified with a rabbit?
第一次见到那米菲是98年嘛，在我在那个荷兰工作的时候。
At the Rijksakademie, yeah.
嗯 ，Rijksakademie 第一次，然后我就觉得第一次我就主要是被他的表情给吸引了。
What kind of expression?
这个表现就是一种说不出来的那么一种，就是他的表情，你也不知道他是在高兴还是悲伤，还是在思考，或者说所有的表情都可以在那个脸上表现出来。我就像看见他，我就像看到了我自己的那个一个自画像一样啊。当就看见米菲了，我就像照镜子一样的感觉。
Then you had this other character. I mean, we're talking about, of course, your previous work, and I think this is the work that you made your breakthrough with. These small, very, you know, beautiful paintings of, well, a rabbit, but also these small girls, these very, these children that also seem to have an indeterminate kind of expression. Would you talk about them?
对，我其实从这么多年工作一直，题材还是很不是在一个题材上，还是很多的题材，因为我觉得，我认为那个题材其实不重要，对一个画家，我可以应该用我的方法去任何事情都可以画。
So you're more of a formalist.
I don't know. I don't know. 我也不清楚我是一个什么主义者，因为我觉得我其实挺怕把自己想象成一个什么风格或者是主义的，所以有时候我工作也有意识的避免这个，去这么去思考，你知道吗？就是最好不要被自己的题材或者是风格或者是。主义所控制，甚至不要被我自己画面的尺寸所控制，就是我有时候画了很大的画，有时候会画很小的画，我会喜欢像凡艾克或者是蒙德里安这种看起来很不一样的东西，因为我觉得不一定只是。一个流派的信徒。
Yes, but I think there is a similarity in perhaps in a certain kind of temperament, even between Mondrian and Van Eyck, and perhaps it's a certain kind of order. Even though one is incredibly closely observed in terms of representing nature, and the other one is.A very pure abstraction. Any comments on that?
I agree totally. So, 这也是我想在我的作品里体现的之一，就是不把所谓具象和抽象和古代或者题材之间的不同认为那么不同，你知道吗？其实他们里边有一个内在的气质的关系是。非常一样的，因为实际上我觉得实际上一个人要想分裂成两个人，实际上是非常困难的，你知道吗？就是即使你在做完全不同的工作，其实还是你这个人，你知道吗
？You might locate a certain kind of longing in your paintings, and we can discuss it a little more. That I think is.Practically there in all of them.
我觉得可能我通过我画画，更多的是发现自己的渴望。因为人真正渴望什么，其实自己有时候往往不知道，你知道。
One thing about these paintings, they look very formal in a way, and in a way they. the blankness gives it a narrative, and the way the pages are about to turn. Would you talk perhaps about maybe the narrative?
这个其实它除了是一本书以外，什么都不是，你知道吗？我认为，我觉得，一个就是画面里一个物体哈、啊，它的象征意义是对我是不重要的，但是它有时候给你带来的一种建筑感和音乐性可能更吸引我啊、它的形状带来的建筑感和音乐性。对，他有时候像，可能像我更多的画的时候，我想起的是那个，比如说巴赫的音乐啊，或者是哥特式的建筑。
I think that you said it's not important what you decide to paint, but I disagree with you because I think you choose very carefully, or you do choose what you paint. So.It's not, as I said, it's not important, is it?
Yes, 是每一其实际上，当你认为每一个题，我认为对于画画来讲最重要的不是题材，但是如果你要当我选择要表达我对绘画认识的时候，我只能选择一类的很有限的题材，比如说，我觉得像塞尚。当他画，他要表现他对绘画的认识的时候，他只能选择苹果去表现，他不能选择画香蕉，你知道吗？你原赛吗 ？It's like Cezanne.
Yes.
When he chose,
with the apple,
he can only apple, but he cannot choose banana to print.
Yeah, he does banana.
对 ，because 就是因为他没法表达他对绘那个香蕉的那个形状。是无法表现他对绘画的那个认识，因为他认为那个他很强烈的认为那个世界是用几个基本的几何体组成的啊，就是 basic， 那几何怎么说
？And his shapes.
Shapes 啊 ，basic shape. Banana is too complicated.
Well,
the form is too complicated.
There is a cylinder, the sphere.
对
，and
对 ，he can only choose apple.我的瓦达瓦，花瓶儿
，pear，
我的 such thing， no， so， but this choice， I think this subject choice， that's what I mean basic from painting， it's not basic from literature，
yeah，
就是说那个题材是选择是基于对绘画的要求，而不是基于对文学和。社会意义上的要求，对，比如说我当时画竹子，不是我基于对竹子对中国传统文化的象征意义，而是基于竹子的形状正好适合于我当时对绘画的表达的用途。当我比如说选择假山石的时候。中国的那个假山石很难表现我当时对绘画的那个本身的追求，是非常难以描述的。Classic， 就是那个文人
The literary scholars, the scholar rocks.
I like, but it's quite difficult for me to in my painting.
But you did do bamboo.
Bamboo.
Yeah.
Because I was.我正好对那个直线还有那个画面结构感兴趣，斑布的形状正适合于我表现这个题材。
Yeah, and they were enormous paintings. They were three panels.
Six meter high, nine meter long.
Okay, but the point is too. I mean, you can talk about structure and line, but of course, if someone it doesn't, you know, I mean, literary or not, whatever.The viewer's approaches. I mean, you're looking at bamboo, and it is, and scholars' rocks for that matter, and they are kind of complicated because they seem to be such cliches too, associated with Chinese art. I don't think you can just get rid of that by saying that you just want to do lines. What do you think?
对，这就是我觉得绘画和绘就是 艺术一幅作品，绘画作品或者艺术作品有意思的地方，就是它只是一个容器，你知道，所有人都可以把它的，就是你艺术家只负责制造一个容器，而观众可以把他的任何理解投射到这里面，而我并不负责给一个明确的答案啊。就是我工作的时候非常，就是我喜欢非常完美和严谨的制作一幅画，但是理解是非常开放的。
And they seem very time consuming also. You know, very, does it take a long time to make?
They yes, look very, yes, very long, yeah, very long.
Many layers of paint.
Yeah. And, yeah. 所以说其实每一幅画到最后我都忘了我画的是什么东西了，你知道。所以比如说像书，当然每个人都知道我画的书，但其实我画画大部分时间我忘了，不是在注意，我是在画一本书，你知道。所以这也就是我觉得它有时候这个物体的选择是一个借口，是一个借口。
And there is no text in your book, no writing.
对，开始我开始的系列，我开始的系列是有具体一本书，甚至还有书的题目的，但是到最近几章就题目什么都没有了。实际上它我就是我看这个书，只是我迷恋于它这个形状和我画面之间的关系。当然，这种一般的这种所有的物体，我选择还都是我自己比较亲近和熟悉的。它就是我觉得绘画其实最重要的一点就是，它要。需要观众长时间的去看一张画，而不像电影主要是两个小时的效果。
The movie is always moving, and it goes from one end to the other, and whatever. But so when do you travel a lot these days, or do you travel?
我那个反正每年都要去，每年都要出去欧洲或美国，或者至少一次。
Does that have any impact on your work?
什么？
对你的那个作品有什么影响吗？
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. It's very, I think it's very important. I need to see. 我需要看比如说各种各样的，就是欧洲的艺术或者美国的全世界。各种各样的艺术，对，很重要，对吧？对，但是我觉得旅行，我从来没度过假，没有一辈子也没度过假，都是一般都是去旅行，去看看艺术啊什么的。因为行，反正对一个艺术家很难有时间休息，你知道吗？就是这一个真正的完全的忘记艺术是不可能的。
Do you think there are more, there's more of an opportunity in Beijing these days also to see more artists from elsewhere, right?
对，现在越来这些年越来越多，越来越多看到比较有质量的the quality work more and more. 但是在北京我更多的是吸取能量，然后去欧洲更多的是为了我的眼睛，是吧？
Oh, that's great. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.